All right, and we're back. Welcome back to our second live HaasTec session for the day. We're over here in the demo room, we're over here in the products area again. And before we get started, I want to just say a big thank you to everyone that's joined us online. We're streaming to both YouTube Live and Facebook Live. Had great turnout on both of those platforms, so thank you very much for doing that. So we're starting here today with Milt Ramirez, one of our product specialists. We were hanging out yesterday over on the APLs.
That was fun.
Today, we're going to take a look at the VC-400. And this is our vertical pallet, our pallet changing vertical is what we're calling this machine. So maybe just let us start us off on this machine. What are you going to typically use this machine for, do you think?
Well, one of the basic advantages that a customer has when they buy a machine like this is that any programs that they might have for a VF1, VF2, any vertical, basically, they can just transfer over to this machine, no editing, and it should run perfectly.
Right, so you have the advantages of a palletized machine,
exactly.
But you're gonna keep all your VMC style programming the same.
Yeah.
That is
potentially a big
advantage for a shop that's focused on VMC work.
Yeah, and obviously the pallet changing, capability of having a part running inside of the work envelope and another station where you can load your new parts or different parts or whatever else you want to run on the machine.
Right, yeah. Just like our HMCs, like an EC400 or whatever, you're keeping the spindle turning while you're loading either new fixturing or new raw blanks or whatever.
Exactly.
Over here.
Yeah, if you have quick change fixturing, you can actually do different setups while the machine is running as well, right? So there's a lot of advantages. This machine could basically run not unattended, but it can run without stopping at all as long as it's being loaded.
Right, you're keeping this middle.
Yeah, keeping it loaded.
You want to move to the controller?
Sure.
Maybe Sal, we can look in the machine here as Milton's talk about some of the features.
Well, as we look inside of the machine, the first thing you're going to see is like a really a spindle that's pretty common to, I would say, 60% of most of the verticals that Haas sells. It's the inline, direct drive spindle, 8100 RPM is standard on this machine. And it has all the cool stuff that we're used to, right? The coolant ring, the nozzles that you can point in all different directions. It has the optional programmable coolant, which is really, really handy. Everybody should have it. And you can get all the normal
options, TSC, P-cool, all those things.
TSC, high pressure coolant, all that good
right.
stuff. And the spindle is also cooled, water cooled, right? It runs inside of the spindle head.
Right.
Just like the other ones as well.
Spindle-wise, you can get different options as well, right? You start with standard is 8,100 RPM, but then you can step up to
10,000, 12,000, 15,000.
And those higher speed spindles are
HSK
taper,
is,
right?
HSK is 12 and 15 only, yeah, HSK
right.
spindle, so that's also an option. So that's really good to know. Also, you have the side mount tool changer, which we won't get a chance to go see in the back, but it's the standard 30+1 that everybody's getting accustomed
right.
to nowadays.
And you can do a 50+1 as well, right? I think.
Yeah, this machine actually has a 50+1 installed on it. It is an option, but the standard one is 30+1. Okay.
So there are big similarities between this machine and the EC400, right?
Yeah, big similarities. It comes with the step column, as we were talking earlier, that gives the machine a little more stability and rigidity when turning or machining heavy cuts.
Right.
Also, the conveyor runs right through the middle of the machine, so all the chips wash down easily and they get moved
right.
out
better
of the way.
Chip wash down and better conveyance.
Yeah,
out.
Which is really important on any machine. The chip evacuation is always super important, right?
Right.
And in terms of comparing with the vertical, this is comparable or right between a VF1 and a VF2. So pretty much the work envelope is the size of a VF2, but the travels are, the x-axis on this vertical pallet machine is 2 inches more on x-axis than a VF1. So actually it's 22 on x, 16 y, and 20 inches on z-axis.
Right.
Okay. Cool. Yep. So, and the table is almost the same size of a VS1 as well.
Right,
it's only
right.
4 inches smaller on length, but the width is 14 also, so 14
and, also,
and a half.
This uses the same kind of hydraulic clamping system that the EC400
yes.
does, right?
Yeah, very important, the hydraulic clamping system for the pallet, right? It's gonna give it its solid hold when you're machining. And the hydraulics are also used for moving or doing the pallet changes as well.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to, I know we've got a note on here to take a look at that probe riser. Do you want to just show that off real
quick?
Yeah,
sure. Yeah, since we have the camera up close over here.
So the probe riser, you can see here, the probe is protected in this little box right here while it's not deployed, but.
Exactly. I'm gonna have to close the door just to initiate the motion by pressing F2 from the device manager. And you can see it rise.
Well, that's how you do it. You press a button and then you.
And then you open
then
it
you
real
open
quick.
The door real quick to see it come up.
So that happens automatically when you're doing, maybe part inspection or you're probing your tools in the middle of a part, just to make sure that it hasn't broken off or whatever. That'll happen automatically, but when you're calibrating your probe, then you do it manually as well. Right. So it's a really cool feature to have. That cover, when it comes down, protects the probe, keeps it clean and free from chips and cooling all the time.
Right.
So let me lower that. Just, there it goes down, it gets covered. So the next thing I want to show here is also a standard feature on this machine, and also the EC400, any palletized machine will have the second home button as standard.
All right.
So what happens is that, let's say you do a tool change, your spindle's gonna be way over there by the tool changer arm. The advantage of the second home button is that when I wanna change tools out by hand, all I have to do is press this button, and there comes the spindle towards
right,
me.
Right, so it's right up front to
so
you
now. So now it's right in front of me, right? That position right there, it's fully programmable. I can put it, position it X, Y, Z axis, wherever I want. And then I can just go to my user settings here, and just by pressing F2, record that position, and that's where the second home button will always send the spindle. Okay?
Right.
So again, the advantages are, you can, like we have inside the machine here, we can see that there's two vices side by side. So I can do one op on one, second op on the other, and have a finished part when it comes out. Right, if you want to do more, I mean, there's narrow vices where you can put maybe three, maybe even four vices side by side.
Right.
Because there are some that are designed for that, where you can, put many vices next to each other.
And you could have that, of course, you could have that doubled over on your other pallet here.
Exactly.
Now, we have two different setups. We're going to look at that in a minute. Mm-hmm. You've got two vices on one, and you've actually got a fourth axis hooked up on the other side.
Exactly.
But you could have that two vice setup replicated out here.
Yeah, the exact same setup. We can have it on the other spindle so that we can run maybe one large batch faster, because we're doing the same thing on two
pallets.
You're
always swapping one finished and one raw every time you're swapping the pallet.
Exactly. And speaking of pallets, that brings up another point on the control specific to this machine.
Yeah, you want to look at the pallet scheduling system, right?
Exactly, the pallet scheduling system. So let's go here to the control, and I think we're going to switch the view to the control itself so that you guys can see on screen. I'm actually in the current commands page. I'm also in the devices tab. Then I move down towards the mechanisms where I can control anything, any option that's installed on the machine. And if I move to the right, that's where I can find the pallet schedule table. Right at this point, one really cool thing about this table is that I can associate a program name to the pallet. Let's say pallet one will always run program 1003. Right, that means that my operator won't make a mistake. He won't run a different program on this particular pallet, right?
Right, right. You know that program is associated with that particular work holding and so forth and so on.
Exactly.
You're not gonna try to load your small vice part into your rotary table.
Exactly, that would be a disaster.
Yeah.
So the scheduler keeps you from doing that. Also, you can work in probing routines or whatever you want to make sure your work holding is correct, your part is located properly, and
all that
good
stuff. And then within your program, you reference that with
by WIPs. Using WIPs and the templates from WIPs, you can program that and edit and add them to your regular program as well.
And so, is there an M code or something you add to the program for the pallet schedule?
Yes. Let's say, like we were saying at the beginning, if you transfer a program from any vertical, it's going to have an M30 at the end for the most part, right? So you just have to change that M30 to M299, and then that tells the pallet scheduler, okay, it's a pallet program, I'm going to go and switch to the next pallet if it's ready, right? So that's what I can do here on the scheduler. I'm on the pallet status column. If I press enter, that brings up my choices. I can unschedule the pallet, I can schedule it, I can say it's missing because it's looking forward to the time when this machine can also be ordered with a pallet pool, right? So if I have a pallet pool, if for whatever reason I took out that pallet from the pallet pool, I can say it's completely missing here, and the machine will never look at that station again, right? It'll completely ignore it.
Until you change the state again.
Until you change the status again, right? I can say it's completed, and it would know to put it away, or it would know not to run it. But in this case, pallet one is inside the machine, it's loaded, so I can actually just leave it as it is. But pallet number two, let's pretend somebody already loaded it, it's ready to go. I can schedule it by going here, choosing number one, and scheduling it. So the pallet now knows that that pallet is ready to go.
Right, right. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So speaking of pallets, I think in a second here, Sal, I think we're going to move in a moment over to the front and take a look at the pallet load station. So, Sal, you want me to follow me over here and
we'll let
Milton come after us here?
So this is what's super cool about a pallet machine, right? Because you have the loading station so that an operator can work on his next job or continuous job while the machine is running, right? That's the major advantage. You're making chips while you're doing something already on a different table or a different particular setup. So it's worth mentioning, as you can see here, that this pallet has a rotary on it. So the machine now is offering a fourth and fifth axis, one axis per pallet at the time. And we're looking forward in the future to making it fourth and fifth for each pallet.
But that's something that's coming
down the line. For now, we can do a rotary on each of the pallets. So really important is that if you do get rotaries on the pallets, then the machine is no longer compatible with the pallet pool.
Right.
Yeah.
You might pull your rotary control
cables
out of your rotary table.
In the way. That's exactly what the problem is.
But there is also the plans to attach a pallet pool to this machine, right?
Yes.
So then you have the same kind of pallet loading function that you have with an EC-400.
Exactly, the same
particular all those benefits
thing.
Of it lights
would be
out.
The 6+1 pallet pool, right? Okay,
So there's some things you want to show us with the pallet changer, right?
Yeah, we always know that, this one, I can't rotate that easily because of that. But it does have a special feature here on the lever that allows me to rotate the pallet.
We'll do a pallet change in a minute here, and then we can take a look at the other station.
But this machine, it has an arrow. The pallet has an arrow facing you, and it also allows this lever to go all the way up. That means the pallet is in the correct position to be able to do a pallet change.
It isn't going to lock out here unless it's in the right place.
Yeah, and
so
if
you
it's
know
not
you're
in the right place, the control knows that too.
Right.
So it will never do a pallet change if it's not in the correct spot. And this is the pallet ready button. Unless this is pushed when the machine is running, then it will never do a pallet change because it knows that the operator's probably still not ready.
I'm assuming you have to have the door closed and press that button.
Yes.
Then it knows it's ready.
That is correct.
Right. So it's not gonna load it if you're here and you have all your tools here and you're still loading your work holding or whatever.
Exactly. It's safe to say that. And also the washdown hose that we have in the front for cleaning the work area, we can also bring that over here and wash down our fixtures, wash down our pallets and the whole area.
Right. Of course, we have our own air gun here as well.
Have the air gun as well.
Right.
So you want me to do a pallet change
for
demonstration purposes? Okay, let me close that door.
Let you push in there, Sal.
Okay, here we go. Beautiful. So here we are.
Okay, here's our second. So this is an example of having two different style jobs on the machine at the same time. You've got rotary on one side, multi-vices here.
Yeah, and by the way, these are the self-centering Haas vices that will be away soon on HaasTooling.com as well.
There you go. Mm-hmm. So you want to show us how that, how those detents work?
So for setup purposes, for changing parts or whatever it may be, I can rotate 360 degrees, right? That's not a problem. I can go all the way around as well. But if I stop in the wrong position here, the lever only goes halfway high. It won't go all the way in. So let's see what happens now. Now it goes all the way up.
Right.
So now it triggers a switch.
So there's a switch on that lever. And so the machine knows if it hasn't made the switch.
That's
it won't
correct.
Let you do it if this thing's in there cockeyed.
That's correct.
Right.
So, and that's basically it,
Cool.